on the track.
You know I didn't ask you to say it. All right. So then, and today we have what? Reezy winning, right?
Reezy winning, yeah.
Yeah, all right. So what's up with you? How you feeling?
That's like $1 million.
$1 million. He didn't say 100.
He said a million.
I'm up feeling like 100. Maybe 1,000 some days, but he said $1 million.
He said $1 million.
Living life.
Yep. Living life to the fullest, you know? So how did you get your name? Reezy winning.
So my name is Kyrie.
Mm-hmm.
So my mom came up with Kyreezy, and then she just started calling me Reezy. And that was when I was like younger.
Gotcha.
And then I put winning at the end of it like last year. I thought it sounded nice.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
How old are you?
14 now.
Oh, okay.
So that means you got COVID, because we used to go to school together.
Yeah.
How old was you then? You had to be like 10.
I went there from 4th grade to 5th grade, so like,
whoa.
I thought he was
like 10 and 11, probably.
That's crazy.
That is. Wait, you going to high school now?
Yeah.
What school are you going to?
Around the corner, OSA.
Oh, okay. So you from Oakland?
I was born in San Francisco, mm-hmm. but I didn't live there for that long, so
okay.
I would say, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you got some SoundCloud music, you know, we want to bump it, you know, we want to hear some, so.
No, you don't.
What's the best song you want us to play right here?
It's called Get To It.
Yeah.
It's Taliban.
Yeah, it's
Taliban. It's quiet, though. I used to dance more because, like, that's what I learned how to do before I learned how to rap. But my granddad, he used to, like, work with MC Hammer, E-40, people like that. So he, like, made me want to start doing it because he used to force me to record.
Oh.
So when I was, like, 5.
That's what's up. That's like, crazy. Just, started? Wait, so you started out when you was around five, or like?
Well, I started liking rap when I was around five. I actually started like doing it when I was like 10.
Okay.
What was your first song when you was 10? Did you make any?
No.
Do you write your own lyrics?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. So what inspires you to rap? Like, or not rap, but like, what inspires you to write? There we go.
I mean, sometimes I just write when I'm bored, mm-hmm. and it's like a lot of challenges, like on Instagram, so sometimes I'll take those beats and I'll write to them.
Mm-hmm.
It's still a lot of challenges I never even did. I wrote to them, because none of my challenges are straight freestyle.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
I write them first, and then I either remember them or mm-hmm. read them.
Got you. So your freestyle was with the beat, right? So you don't, like, just... Like, what do you mostly write about, though? If you had to choose one thing that you mostly write about, what is it?
I mean, I try not to be, like, how every open rapper has, everybody want to sound like S.O.B. or every... It's either, like, it's two different types of open rappers. Mm-hmm. You can either be the type that you want to, like, sound like wavy or whatever you want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
Or, like, you could try to take the S.O.B., you feel me, mm-hmm. first class. So I try not to rap about like stuff that's not really, that doesn't
make sense, relevant.
Well, not, yeah, that doesn't like appeal to me.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes if I'm bored, I'll just write like whatever.
Mm-hmm. So how do you feel about flexing, or do you do it yourself, or what?
I feel like it's two different types of flexing.
Mm-hmm.
You could flex like because you're happy that you got it, or you could flex just because you got it. Like some people, sometimes they flex because like for example, when I pulled this money out, this is mm-hmm. not a lot of money. So
this was $30.
But like, fair. I feel like people sometimes they try to flex on somebody, or you just like regularly do. I feel like it could be taken the wrong way depending on how you do it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so like, do you have any haters or like snakes or anything, or you just don't deal with that? You like, nah, man, like I. You don't care, like what?
Well, I mean, I don't really. I get along with everybody mm-hmm. except for my siblings. So like, it's people that don't like me or like mm-hmm. that I got a problem with. But I wouldn't say they like they're haters. I mean, mm-hmm. they got a problem with me over something that I like I can't control.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't say that it's haters only because like I don't. They're not
relevant.
Yeah. Right.
Top five rappers.
In the world or in Oakland?
In Oakland. I knew that.
It's a lot of people. I would say I pay more attention to producers than rappers because a lot of people try to sound the same. I don't listen. Like, I wouldn't say S.O.B. only because, yeah, that's not it. Kind of, yeah. Oakland rappers, I'll say Boovy because he make most of his music, like, just off the top. I would say Booby, and then I'm gonna say what other rappers? I'm trying to think. I can't think right now.
Yeah, Flocka.
Oh yeah. Even though he kind of changed his style, I like it though.
Yeah.
Like I wouldn't identify him if I didn't know who he was. I wouldn't think that he was from Oakland.
Mm. Well, how do you think Oakland rappers sound? Like, do you think they have a specific sound? Like, when you listen to music, you're like, oh, he's from Oakland, because I can tell, like, how he speaks or how he pronounces his words, or no? Like,
I mean, Oakland people, like, they make a lot of the beats sound the same. A lot mm-hmm. of the lyrics sound the same. Mostly Oakland rappers, Bay Area rappers, period.
Mm-hmm.
Like, at least around my age, they mm-hmm. only rap about girls they had sex with or didn't have sex with,
mm-hmm.
guns that they don't have, weed yeah. that they can't afford, belts that their friends let them borrow.
Oh, that's shit.
Fake belts, too.
You can
yeah.
get one at Marshall's, that fake, you know, Gucci belt. You know.
Yeah, fake Ferragamo from the A-Rab across the street for $50. That's what you can get.
He said A-Rab. Right, but so you don't really flex like you. Okay, so what is your main goal with your career, or is this not your career? This is just something to do.
I mean, my mom told me not to get my hopes up just because like it's
the entertainment business.
In today, mm-hmm. it's not that easy.
Yeah,
and it gets harder and harder to like do it each day because it's new people being discovered every day. So I wouldn't say that this is like my only plan, but I also feel like I'm better than a lot of people out here.
Yeah,
that's just my personal opinion. So I could either make money off of it or I can't. So it's like a go for it type of situation.
So are you in this for the money, the fame, the girls, or just getting your word out there? Or,
well, I mean, I do it because it's like something to do. And I like to make music because I like music. So if the money and all that other stuff comes with it, then yeah, but I'm not really focused on it. That's not the problem.
Yeah,
let me talk. What you doing outside of this? Like, any sports or something like that?
I don't play sports. I can. Like, I'm okay in basketball. Despite what people may think. I can shoot. That's about it.
Okay. So, but, like, I know you said, like, music's not your main focus. So, what is your backup career, then?
My backup career? I mean, I don't really know. I haven't figured that out yet.
He's 14.
I plan on doing something kind of like, okay, well, since I have to do this, I'll do it. So I plan on like going to college and seeing what I want to do and then just sticking with that. So my plan was that if I haven't, if I don't feel like any way successful in music by the time I'm 16, then I'll probably stop or at least take a break.
What's your biggest pet peeve in rappers?
Like, I got a few. It's like some people, they say the same thing over and over. Like, I mean, some people, I don't like when people call themselves rappers and that's not what they do. Like, some, like, I wouldn't, Young T.O., that's not a rapper. That's a singer because he sings. He doesn't rap a lot. So I would say he's a singer, not a rapper. Don't call yourself a rapper if that's not what you do. And then also just like bad quality music. Like if you record it off your phone, don't put it out.
Yeah,
I mean, people got studios at their house and it comes out nice, but like if it doesn't sound good, don't.
Don't let it go.
Yeah.
And then last thing would probably be just people who try to sound like alike. And people who repeat themselves in their music, like, if you say the same, I mean, you might be able to use the same bar, like, once or twice, but if you say one bar, and then you keep going, and then you use that bar over and over again,
yeah,
don't rap.
I know exactly what you're talking about. What's some of the producers you work with so far?
I mean, usually I get beats off YouTube, but I don't have a lot of music, so. The only producer I would say I worked with, like, actually, would be Taliban.
So, do you, like, who is, if you had to work with anyone in this business, who would be?
In Oakland or just anybody?
Anybody. Dead or alive, too.
What if they're in jail?
Okay.
Take K.
Oh, duh. You know who TK is?
No.
What?
I don't really listen to
him. You never heard The Race?
What?
Murder, She Wrote. Never heard The Race.
Oh, I heard Murder, She Wrote.
By TK.
What? Sure.
She don't know TK. That's crazy.
I don't really, you know, listen to rap like that.
Who's TK?
That's crazy.
Whatever. Whatever. Anyways, so we have this little segment or whatever where we let our rappers freestyle. So you got a freestyle?
I'm not a real freestyler.
You ain't got no verses?
Nope.
I got a little something. I got a little something?
I can see. All right,
let me see. It depends on what beat you pick though.
Ooh. Like, what's your type of style rapper? Like slow, medium, fast?
I could do either one. I like to do like medium, I'll say, because like sometimes I got punchlines and I want to make sure people hear.
So if I gave you, I just sent this to Tio. He told me to send it to him. So if I give you this one, what do you think you gas on it?
Depends.
Let's hear it. Let's see.
I'm not gonna sing though.
Hold on, let me see.
yeah.
He said, I'm not gonna sing though. I'm a rapper, not a singer.
Let me hear it out first. On to the next. Chasing money since I bagged the clout. Don't trip off them haters. Ain't no telling what they mad about. Must really want to jab it out. Brody want to pump me, but don't know me. What is that about? Ooh. I need no effort, no help. I've been cold and I won't melt. Mm. I stand up, I don't fall well. I'm 10 toes, yeah, I hold well. You talking fire, I'ma show hell. Go 12 rounds, get the gold belt.
Ooh.
Spanish friendly, a whole shell. When you get hit, it's Taco Bell.
What? My man said, Spanish friendly, a whole shell. What the fuck? This man is 14.
Right. Got sickness. Bars sickness. For days. Like,
I feel like if I got in the studio more, I'd probably be able to freestyle better.
Mm-hmm.
Cause like, when I write stuff, I don't, like, have to wait and think about it. Like, I could write a whole song in about 5 minutes.
Show Taco Bell!
Damn. Wow. You really clever with yours. You didn't write this out? You just freestyle on beat?
Oh, no.
You don't gotta watch out for him.
See,
dang.
Like, I can't freestyle fast. Oh, like, I can't. No. Like, I can't do that yet. But, like, if I take, like, 5 seconds to think about it, I can do that.
That's the first real
right.
Freestyle. I mean, well, J-Walk came out.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, J-Walk said what's up.
Oh, yeah.
And, what's his name? Ajay Kassim.
Yeah, Ajay Kassim. They came and freestyled. That was the first freestyle they did. Mm-hmm. They came. But, yeah, I don't know.
That was dope. Like, you didn't even have to think. Like, he was just
that
like.
That was nice. His last 2 bars killed it. I didn't think that was going to come out.
Right.
That was sick.
You can use a metaphor. It's like.
I try to think about my stuff more so that, like,
it makes sense.
Less catchy, more like you actually think about it. Because mm-hmm. I get most of my inspiration. Like, I don't copy off the rappers, or I try not to.
Mm-hmm.
But usually, like, if I'm bored, I'll listen to music, and then that makes me write. And mm-hmm. then, like, I think about it.
Yeah, that's crazy. That man said, oh, my God. Man, well.
That's crazy.
I never heard that. That was nice. I can't even, I don't know.
Right.
Star
it's
Trek.
Like,
that was nice.
Oh, my God.
So, yeah, we definitely got to, yeah, I'm going to send you some stuff.
Yep.
I'm going to send you some.
Yep, SB on the track, by the way, is a producer, you know. So
That was like a quick little 8 and killed it.
I got a question.
It was simple.
For you.
Yeah.
So, say, I mean, I don't know if you do the freebie YouTube type thing.
Yeah.
But say you post to be on YouTube mm-hmm. for nonprofit, so, like, it's free,
yeah.
but for nonprofit. And somebody uses it, and their song get big, and they start making money off it. Would you be mad and try to cash in off that, or would you just let it be?
It's a free beat.
Dang.
It's your fault. I mean, if anything, you could put a link in there. You can put a link and be like, you can email, title it, whoever, type beat, purchase.
A lot of producers, they complain that, like, this is the year of the complaining producers.
Mm-hmm.
Producers complain about new stuff every day, so they complain about people stealing beats or not paying for them. But I don't see how, like you know, Cardi,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
his producers, all his producers say he don't pay for his beats. But it should be no way for him to get the beat if he didn't pay for it.
Mm-hmm.
You can't try to cash in after the fact.
Right. That's why me, I let you hear snippets of it. That's why I don't put my beats anywhere downloadable. Or stream, like, you cannot see or hear any of my beats unless I go live.
It do bother me though sometimes. Yeah. People post beats and then they got that purchase your track.
that's
on the best beats.
Right.
Yeah, but you know the cost to have it, right?
Yeah, that's the thing about rappers too. Like they want to be rappers, they just want to put the money in.
But also
they're scared.
I could like, see at the same time like why a person would steal a beat because if it's a beat for sale and it's like, you know, tags on it and it's a good beat, you could take that and you could use it, but
mm-hmm.
you're not sure if you're gonna make money off of it, so why would you pay somebody?
Right.
That's like,
but then if you do, they can sue you. That's even worse. Mm-hmm. So now you got to.
Depending on how petty the producer is.
Right, that too. It all depends on what, you know, the situation is. But if you still would beat off, you know what I'm saying, and tell you to purchase it, purchase your track today, got that whole thing on, you cut it up, chop it up, rap on it, you get big. Mm-hmm.
But how does this make sense? How do rappers get more money than the producers?
Because they don't get booked for shows. Producers don't get booked for shows.
Plus, rappers don't just have, like, their songs, and then they put it out, and they get paid for it. They got features, they get booked for shows. Some producers, like, pay people to take their beats.
Yeah, pay people to come into the studio and rap on a beat. That's what I was thinking about a few times. Mm-hmm. But I ain't got to talk about these boy or, you know, whoever it is. Yeah. It is.
It makes so,
but, yeah. That's why I got into leasing. Mm-hmm. Leasing beats is, you know, it's a, however many copies could be sold. Yeah. And it'd be like 2,500 people take the same copy, but it's a lease. So,
well, I guess that's the entertainment business.
Man.
And most people be copying now, like copying beats or whatever, and then like they just steal it and then like remake it or whatever. But,
yeah.
But I don't know. Aren't you guys worried about copyright? Like, even, no, you could even get sued for saying a lyric that someone else, like a legend, probably said.
That's why you don't copy off.
Are you worried about it? Because let's say you hear like a big one, you're like, man, I kind of want to use it. Would you use it?
It depends. Like, it's a difference between hearing a line in an SLB song and hearing a line in like a Dr. Dre song. Like, you hear a line in a Dr. Dre song, you might be able to use. Don't use SLB. They're not that big yet. It's like, you get sued for nothing, basically.
That's true. Okay. Because I was say, like, aren't you worried about copyright? He's like, hey, you stole that line from so and so. And then it's like, you know, you can't really do nothing about it because it's already out there. The song's already out there.
That's why I make my lines. Like, I try to make them the best lines. Mm-hmm. So people want to steal my lines.
Mm-hmm. Would you get mad if people stealing your lines?
I don't have a lot of music out, so I wouldn't say that people, like, copy me. I don't think that would happen. But if it did happen, I wouldn't get mad. It's just, like, it's already somebody doing this. It's, like, so.
Yeah.
You make a song identical to SLB with a different beat.
Mm-hmm.
You're not gonna get as big as them, so it's like no reason.
Yeah. How did you build your fans or your supporters, or people just listen to you and believe that, you know, this is what I want to do for now, and you know, listen to my music or whatever.
I mean, I feel like I'm not gonna say nobody supports me or nobody believes me, but everybody wants to like be a rapper nowadays.
That's
so
true.
Some people pay less attention to it. And then everybody has this thing about SoundCloud artists. But it's a difference between having a, like, a SoundCloud and your music is trash and having it, like, it's basically just putting music out there.
Yeah.
It's the same thing as it being on Spotify. Or, I mean, it's not the same thing, but basically.
Yeah. Because, you know, people put down SoundCloud artists because they're like, take those SoundCloud out your bios because y'all know that y'all trash or something. Let's see what we say.
There's a lot of people, like, I have friends that don't really support me, but, like, if I was to come out with a song, they're not gonna like talk down on it. And then I have friends like, or people who used to be my friends. And when I came out with my song, the song that y'all just played, I sent them the link and he told me that it was good or whatever. He played it on Snapchat, everything. Now this year, later on, we got beef or whatever you want to call it. And he wanna say, oh, I'll rap about stuff that I'm not about and I can't rap and this and that.
Exactly.
His girlfriend liked my music though.
Well, I mean, I guess it's for the ladies or whatever. Like, are you single, taking, chilling, being a P or whatever? Especially you just now going to high school. I don't think you should be taking, but you know.
That depends. I got a couple text backs.
Oh, so you don't be texting back females? You just be leaving them on red.
Sometimes.
I'm
not one of the people who like, I'm not gonna leave you on red because I think I'm too good for you. At the same time though, everybody in Oakland knows everybody, and like you can just feel when it's not worth it. And if it's not worth it, I'm not gonna continue to talk to you.
Dang. Will you let them know that like I don't want to really like talk to you, or you just,
because that's when girls start getting mad. They start posting on their Snapchat.
But they get mad when they get left on red or like not even spoken to, so that's worse. It's like it's a lose lose actually.
If you see yourself getting left on red continuously, just stop texting. Me, are you gonna keep fighting the person who you know can like beat you up?
No, but I mean you gotta defend yourself. Look,
you ever got a whooped for the same thing twice?
No, well, I don't know. It depends. Anyways, that's not the point. The point
what
is,
what would you do if he was in a Meek Mill, Nicki Minaj type relationship? So like you went out with a female rapper.
We gonna make some
both of y'all was the same. Both of y'all was the same. Y'all was both coming up just the same. Y'all just kept growing. Like, would it be like? What would you think it would be like?
I mean, that's a good question. Cause like, if y'all break up, she not even gonna sing Lil Kayla. She gonna make a song about you. She gonna come out.
That's
not really
true.
And in that case, I don't feel like. I feel like Meek Mill's one of the best rappers out. Period. And a lot of people don't give him that credit because like
he lost to Drake.
He didn't lose to Drake, in my opinion. I mean, his diss tracks were whack, but at the same time. I feel like Drake, he's four diss tracks. He like, that's the type
Drake
of stuff you do.
What?
I've never heard Drake freestyle before.
I don't think
look up one of his interviews.
I've never heard anything. Have you heard
him? Chris Brown freestyle better than Drake.
Yeah, I'm going to say.
That is true. Because I did see a freestyle. Cause
Drake is very lyrical and smart.
Drake should stick to singing.
At the same time, we're like, Meek Mill's thing was and he was at Summer Jam. I didn't think he was going to come out. Did you go to Summer Jam? Oh my god, Summer Jam. When he came out, I was like, what the heck?
I only like one song by him, so.
That's the one you're at this year, huh?
Yeah.
Line.
I don't care because I don't like him.
I don't
care.
Sound like that.
I don't! And shut up! But
I'm more R&B old school. But I feel like Meek Mill as a rapper, period. Not even just music wise. One of the best rappers out because, like, he came up from the struggle and he don't like. That's not all he ever talks about. Like, he can rap about different things. His freestyles are good. And even though, like, a lot of people say stuff about him or, like, he came up from, like, the streets, he don't, like, he's cool about it.
Yeah. So, like, do you have a struggle or anything? Or, like, you, like, living in the hills and stuff, and, like, everything's kind of handed to you? I mean, I'm not judging you. I'm just asking.
A lot of people... See, that's the idea that a lot of people have. A lot of people think that because you grew up a certain way or because you grew up somewhere, that's what makes you. That's not what makes you. Mm-hmm. I could grow up, like, in one of these apartments over here and be harder than somebody that's from the 30s or something like that. Like, it's all about who you are. And being, like, a thug is becoming a trend.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a lot of people, rappers especially, that's not really like doing it like they said it is.
Yeah.
My struggle is different though. Like, I wouldn't say it's a struggle because my mom worked hard. Like, if anybody struggled, it was her. That's why I rap. Mm-hmm. I rap so that if possible, I can make money off of that and support her. Not because I'm living in a trap house. Nothing like that.
Yeah. I got you.
Who's your favorite rapper from this year?
From this year. I feel like it was a good year for female rapper. I feel like it was a good year for Cardi B.
Mm-hmm.
She fine, so I'm
dang! Oh my god, y'all should have saw his face.
Cardi B.
She is bad!
Yep. It's crazy,
man. Yeah. You's a lie.
It's crazy.
Honestly, she's like. Oh my god, what was that? Anyways.
Alright, what about the male?
It's a lot of people who sounded the same. I feel like SOB is not going to be a good year for... I'm not going to say that it's going to be a bad year for them next year, but I feel like First Class is next up next year. Possibly.
Yeah, they are coming out from here. So I like the music, so... Yeah.
First Class, you think SOB is going to last?
Ooh, yeah. That rhymed.
The reason why SOB wouldn't last is because a lot of people try to sound like them.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you coming out with music that sound like this person, when they come out with their music, nobody's going to want to listen to it. They already heard that, basically.
Yeah. Well.
And a lot of people aren't listening to rappers anymore because rappers keep doing dumb stuff.
Yeah. dumb and irritating. That's why, I don't know. I don't really listen to rap because I feel like I just keep on hearing the same shit and it's just like...
I don't listen to it that much either because I don't like disrespect. I don't like to hear, listen to disrespectful music all the time. Like,
disrespectful music, what do you mean?
Disrespect means like, in their music, they disrespect females. Or they talk about, like I'm gonna kill you, I'm gonna blah blah. Like, I don't want to hear it all the time. Like, it's just annoying. Because, like you said, it is the same. Like, it's like, not everybody could be a killer. Like, please, let's just get a handful
of people listening. People listen to y'all and they think that make them shit.
Yeah.
Even when rappers nowadays try to be romantic or whatever, they still just talk about fucking them, but like in a nicer way.
I mean, I feel like as a rapper, a lot of people don't think you're supposed to be romantic. So when you finally come out with a song that's remotely positive towards ladies, everybody's gonna be like, he's not that bad after all. At the same time, like, I take Chris Brown for an example. That's one of my biggest inspirations. He dance, act, direct, sing, all that.
Yeah.
Now, he could either rap about, like, taking your girl and smashing her, leaving her the next day. But he could also make better music that's talking about, like, the good.
Yeah. Ooh, I used to be a big fan of Chris Brown. I still, I was just like, I'm not, like, a big fan. Like, oh my God, he came out with a new song! Like, I'm not like that.
You know who you made that to? First class day. She said Zay came in, Zay and GDA came in. She's like, oh my God,
GDA. No, shut up. Okay, look, I'm just a fan of people, okay?
I seen GDA walking down the street not that long ago. It was like last year.
No, it's just like if I listen to your music and then like I see you, I'm like, oh my God. Like,
but they just go to school around the corner.
I know that. That's not the point. The point is if I listen to your music and I'm a fan, then it's like, oh my God. It's first class Zay, first class GD, first class Monte. I'm like, I'll be fanning out. I don't know why. Don't judge me, okay? It just happens. So,
I feel like it was a good year for Gucci, though. I never.
Oh, yeah.
He getting married, so.
Like, he came out of jail and took over again.
And he lost heck away.
Picked up where he left off.
So, that is it for today. We have Reezy winning, SB on the track, and Radio 9. And you can follow me on the gram, Radio 9.
Don't follow her. Follow me.
Okay, I was going to shout you out, but now you do it too much. Anyways, follow me on the gram, Radio 9 _. Follow SB on the track.
SB on track on Instagram. SBONA track.
People get it. All right.
Because I have somebody on one of my beats and they say SB on the track.
Oh. Like
SBONDA. I was like, oh, no.
No, it's just on it. Like, ONA.
SB on the track.
It's
exactly how you say it. You don't say SB on the track.
I'm going to give a quick shout out to my mom for letting me out the house today.
right. Strict moms. But anyways, and follow Reezy Winning at Reezy Winning on the gram. Any like SoundCloud they want to follow or Twitter?
I'll let y'all know. Y'all could add me on Snapchat, Reezy Winning. Follow me on Twitter, Reezy Winning. But don't get mad if I talk about you, though.
He be throwing blimps. But, that was it. I'm your hostess with the mostest, and I am.